Mae Jemison, the first African-American female to explore space.
Mae Carol Jemison flew off to space on September 12, 1992 on the mission STS-47, which was the first joint U.S.-Japan mission. Mae also was the first African-American female astronaut.
Mae worked alongside Jan Davis, Mark Lee, and other astronauts from Japan. Jemison and Davis were both mission specialists, meaning that they were in charge of conducting the experiments on the trip. They experimented with the reproduction of frogs and how tadpoles develop in space.
This exploration is a significant part of history because Mae inspires many young women to demand to be involved. She inspires not only kids, but everyone to follow their dreams and to never limit yourself because of others' limited imagination.
Mae was born in Decatur, Alabama on October 17, 1956.
Mae found her love for science at a very young age. In kindergarten, when her teacher asked the students what they wanted to be when they grew up, she said she wanted to be a scientist without hesitation.
Her teacher responded to her by asking, "Don't you mean a nurse?" Mae was doubted like this often and received lots of negative comments, but her parents always supported her. While Mae would spend a lot of her free time reading things about science at the library, she really enjoyed modern dance and was in a modern dance club in high school. Bio.com explained how she spent a considerable amount of time in her school library reading about all aspects of science, especially astronomy. During her time at Morgan Park High School, she became convinced that she wanted to pursue a career in biomedical engineering, and she graduated in 1973 as a consistent honor student, as Bio.com also explained. After high school, she entered Stanford University on a National Achievement Scholarship.
According to the National Air and Space Museum, Mae received her medical degree from Cornell University and served 2 years in the Peace Corps in West Africa as a staff physician. She later on decided that she wanted to be an astronaut and was one of the 15 chosen in a pool of 2,000 applicants. Mae explained in her autobiography what training to be an astronaut is like. They learned about spacecraft, orbital dynamics, planetology, and how the human body adjusts to weightlessness. But most of all, they learned about each other. Mae went through intense training and she learned that astronauts fly and train in two-seater supersonic T-38 jets. They took survival training to learn what to do if there was a problem and they had to eject from the airplane. On September 12, 1992, the space shuttle Endeavour carried her and six other astronauts on 126 orbits around the Earth. When she did finally fly in space, the first thing she saw was Chicago, her hometown. It was such a significant moment for her because ever since she was a little girl, she had always assumed she would go to space. Looking out the window of that space shuttle, she thought if that little girl growing up in Chicago could see her older self now, she would have a huge grin on her face. Everyone's a rocket. In an interview, Mae explained she was in training from when she was born until she became an astronaut, because as an astronaut, you use all the skills you learn in life. As a mission specialist, Jemison was a co-investigator of two bone cell research experiments, one of 43 investigations that were done on mission STS-47.
Here Jemison is testing an IV on a fake hand to make sure that this amount of fluid taken in by someone can be controlled in weightlessness. This is an example of a simulator. Simulators can range from machines to whole rooms, and they control or simulate things that go on in the shuttle. An example is the flight of the shuttle.
Over the course of her only off-planet voyage, Jemison logged 190 hours, 30 minutes, and 23 seconds in space. The shuttle landed at Kennedy Space Center in Florida on September 20th. Space.com said that Jemison left NASA in March 1993.
But that didn't mean that her journey as a scientist would end. May stayed a very successful woman.
She also started the Jemison Group, an organization that does research and technology. Her determination to fulfill her dreams continues to inspire the next generation. The Jemison Group is seeking to encourage a love of science in students and bring advanced technology around the world. She was a great role model, and she was even someone's woman crush Wednesday. May also wrote her own autobiography called Where the Wind Goes. After May left NASA, she even became the first real astronaut on Star Trek. She left NASA because she's very interested in how social sciences interact with technologies.
Even though May's flight in the shuttle Endeavour was over 20 years ago, she will never be forgotten. She's an inspiration to young and old. She's an active public speaker and continues to urge students to pursue their dreams and pursue math and science. She stresses the importance of excelling in school. Because of her achievements, a school in Detroit was named in her honor, the May C. Jemison Academy. Dr. Jemison gladly accepted the position of role model and hoped to remind other African Americans that the sky is the limit. She also founded and directs The Earth We Share, an international science camp for kids between 12 and 16. As May once said, this trip brought me fame, honors and awards such as induction into the National Women's Hall of Fame, letters from people all around the world. But most significantly, my role in the spaceflight made me a stronger, more visible platform from which to discuss the importance of individuals taking responsibility, not only for themselves, but also how they treat others and this planet.